Hi, I'm Nuno from Imaginando, and today we have exciting news for you iOS musicians. We have released LK172, which includes a lot of fixes and some new cool features that I want to show you. Let's start by opening AUM and make LK as a MIDI processor. All right, so now let's open Ruismaker and drop a basic beat. So let's route LK into Ruismaker and choose to receive MIDI only on channel one. And now let's create a clip. Okay. Okay, let's create a new track now and let's open DRC. So now we are going to route channel 2 from LK to DRC. Let's create a clip. Okay, this sounds dark enough just to have a background layer. So when I created a new track, it automatically selected channel 2 as output MIDI channel. And LK input and LK output are automatically chosen as input and output devices by default. This will improve your workflow. And this was a feature suggestion that we have implemented. So what's really new about this version? You now have a long press on the clip that will open a context menu. With this feature, you can open a properties panel, which is also accessible in the already existing clip composer panel by toggling this icon over here, the inspector icon. Okay, in this properties panel, you can name the clip. So let's choose bass here, and you can choose a new color for the clip, and you can automatically you can choose the length of the clip over here. So you can do it manually by dragging the finger here, or by pressing the buttons twice two or divide by two. There is also a new feature which is MIDI triggering. So you can use an external keyboard or controller to trigger this clip by choosing the channel and the CC of that controller. that you want to assign the clip to. So right now, as you can see, we have the bass clip. Let's select the other clip and choose like drums. Okay. Oh. Let's now create a new scene. So we want to improve the drums. Let's pass this clip over here and do some changes. Sorry, let's redo this. Okay. Let's just make a small change. Sorry, I have this toggle. Let's now duplicate this one as well. Let's add it. I'm getting tired of this bass sound. Let's search for another one. Okay, more groovy. So, let's try to trigger these clips from a MIDI controller. Let's first do something. Let's add a new node over here and add this inspector MIDI spy so we can know which CC from these pads are we going to use. So let's select here Arturia MiniLab, open the inspector and click on the pad. Channel 1 CC 36. So now we go to LK and we choose, for instance, the drums, and we choose channel 1, CC 36. Okay. And we do the same for the other clip. Channel 1, CC 36. All right, so let's see what happens when I press this pad. Oops, nothing. Fantastic. Oh, I see. The problem is that we don't have Arturia MiniLab routed into LK. So let's choose here and try again. All right, so one more thing, one more cool feature we have implemented is the follow action of a clip. If you choose next, it will play the next clip. Okay, let's try again. Launch here. And now it will jump to the next. Okay, but you can also do a random jump. So right now we are on a clip. Let's choose random. In this case, doesn't really matter because there is only one option. But if we add a long list of scenes, you could jump randomly in the same track between the clips in that track. Yeah, so these are the big features that we have implemented, but we have definitely gave a big focus on stability and CPU usage, and we are looking forward to see what your feedback is. So please try it and let us know what you think of LK172. Goodbye and see you on the next video.